Hey everybody, this is Fast Lenny on the mic with OnTheRailTV.com. We're going to have the finals here at Saratoga. It's going to be race to 11. One set. Rodney Morris versus Mark Vidal. Rodney's just hitting some balls warming up. In the meantime, we're going to thank some of our sponsors before we kick off. We got Andy Billiard Cloth, Sinclair, Wyoming, Refining Company,
Rodney Morris for the title. They agreed to play one race.
Dragon Promotions,
Masters Saratoga,
Carbon County Visitors Council,
Table 1, Mark Vidal, Rodney Morris,
Shively Hardware,
Rodney Morris, Table 1, for the Masters Saratoga Championship,
Dermot Hughes, Molinari. You can pick it up at HighRockStore.com. The Last Forever Tip Tool. QB Custom Cues. And Lights Out Billiards Apparel. Also want to thank McDermott for all their support. And Remove Names. .com, along with Town Tips. So let's kick it off. Mark Vidal to break. Well, Mark starts it off with a scratch on the break, and Rodney's gonna have cue ball in hand. Not the way you want to start it off, but it's a long set. Race to 11.
Harry Duncan, report for the contest. Harry Duncan, we're still here, report for the tournament test.
Rodney gets the first game. Yes. take a look at the layout here. See what Rodney's working with. Tough action here. The striped one and solid one are available, but the balls are tied up. The six ball and the striped four ball and the striped five and solid five are tied up. So, you know, with this game, if you've never experienced or don't know anything about it or watched it, you gotta play the either solids or stripes, whichever one you select, in order. So, Rodney's electing to take the stripes. And he shoots them in order, 1 through 6, either solids or stripes, and then the black ball for the win. Mark asked if he was solid, and yes, he is solid, Rodney had said, and he's going to be jumping at the one ball, most likely, unless he can find a good place to kick. But I think he'll go to the air. Called safe. And it worked out pretty good for him. Rodney will be able to go rail first, it looks like. Possibly. And, yeah, it's a good shot. He kicked and played it that way, and he did a great job. We're going to see some good safety play from both these guys. When the table gets a little funky like this, you're going to see a lot of safety play and strategy, and it makes the game interesting. And some creativity when people have to run out. You'll see kicking and banking and jumping. You'll just see almost everything. It's really a great game. There we go. Jump safe. I hope your audio and video is coming in good. You're all enjoying the stream. We've been bringing a lot of pool to you here today. And tomorrow, we'll be having 8-ball all day for you guys to watch. I think you guys will enjoy that. 8-ball all day long for Sunday. You're watching the 2016 High Desert Shootout and on therailtv.com. And this is Fast Lenny on the mic. We're at the Jeffrey Memorial Center. Rodney Morris won the 10-ball finals earlier in less than 20 minutes with a score of 6-0 over Chris McDaniel, who finished third here in the Saratoga division. And now you are seeing him here in the finals with Mark Vidal. Rodney trying to go for a trilogy, trying to get this and then possibly the 8-ball tomorrow. But he's got to get past Mark Vidal first, and Mark is a very cagey player, very smart player. So they're going to have a ref come over, because he's going to be trying to make a hit here, a kick on the one, and it's close to the five. And we'll zoom in on this kick so, you know, we can get a better view of it. He's playing the one ball. The solid one ball. Foul. And ball in hand. For Rodney.
Johnny Aguilar, Johnny 5, if you're in the room, report to the tournament desk. Johnny Aguilar, to the tournament desk, if you're in the room. Daryl Sellis, report to the tournament desk. Daryl Sellis, to the tournament desk. Thank you.
Rockets on the board is 1-1. Mark Vidal is leading 2-1.
On the Wire, creative media helps billiards companies increase sales, gives professional pool players a chance to make a living through real sponsorship, and takes new ideas through execution to completion. Through the use of visual aid, video production, photography, social media, and more.
Thank you.
just like that, we're tied at two.
Did you find some damaging information about you online? Are you or your business a victim of online slander? If so, we can help. RemoveNames.com is the number one damage control firm and reputation management company in Maryland, and we do business all over the world. RemoveNames.com is a name you can trust. Contact us to get your negative information removed. Call us today for a free consultation at 1-866-848-2022 or email us at support@removenames.com. From CEOs to pool players, your reputation is our business.
We're tied at 2 in this race to 11. So Radney's calling the one. He's gonna play that off the five ball. Selecting to take the solids. Don't know if he got there or not. I don't think so. And he might be kicking for the chicken here. It's close. Let's take a look at the other camera angle. Don't know about this one. Oh, there we go. Now Mark has to make contact with that striped one ball, striped yellow, down in the top left-hand corner, as you see it on your screen. Otherwise, it would be cue ball in hand for Rodney. So just solids and stripes, 1 through 6. It's a special custom ball set, Saratoga ball set. So 1 through 6, and then the black ball.
Want to take another look at those fine Civili cues over the Civili cues booth, or looking at the pool accessories or any shirts?
I think the 5 gets past the one ball, the striped one ball in that corner. Not sure yet. We'll have to see what Rodney chooses to do.
Thank you.
3-2, and looks like a player timeout. We'll be back shortly. We're going to run a few commercials. Stay tuned in, everybody.
Hi, I'm Rockin' Rodney Morris, and welcome to my DVD, Rockin' Science.
Did you find some damaging information about you online? Are you or your business a victim of online slander? If so, we can help. RemoveNames.com is the number one damage control firm and reputation management company in Maryland, and we do business all over the world. RemoveNames.com is a name you can trust. Contact us to get your negative information removed. Call us today for a free consultation at 1-866-848-2022 or email us at support@removenames.com. From CEOs to pool players, your reputation is our business.
We're just waiting for Mark to get back. Appreciate everybody tuning in. We'd like to thank some sponsors here. Andy Billiard Cloth, obviously. Sinclair Wyoming Refining Company, Dragon Promotions, the Carbon County Visitors Council, Shively Hardware, locally owned since 1925, we have McDermott Cues, Molinari Gloves, you can get them at highrockstore.com, Lights Out Billiards Apparel, QB Custom Cues. And if you enjoy the streams, you can always support through PayPal. Or pick up Rocket Science in the On The Rail TV Pro Shop. Well, Mark is back, leading 3-2 in this race to 11. Thank RemoveNames.com and Town Tips. Appreciate all the fan and sponsor support out there. See, as we look at this table, since the striped one ball has went down, if Mark wanted to take stripes, he would have to shoot the striped two ball. That's the striped blue ball, obviously. You know, we all know the colors and how they work. Or he can shoot at the solid one. So he's got a pick. Looks like he's going to play a three ball combination to kick off with. And that's what he's done. And the table's opened up nicely for him now. Yeah, if you're watching, please share the stream link. Let everybody know that they can watch some live free pool here. Thank you.
Jana Thompson, report to the tournament desk. Jana Thompson to the tournament desk.
Score is now 5-2. Stream out there, and make sure to share that stream link, let everybody know that they can watch some live free pool at ontherailtv.com. Either share that link or the Ustream link, either one is fine. Let's see how Mark breaks the balls here. Doesn't have a good opening shot here on either of the one balls, the striped one or the solid one. So what Mark might elect to do is probably play a safety. He'll bank this one ball, the striped one, up by the solid one, and then get his cue ball covered up, and Rodney will be having to kick at one of those two, like so. Rodney's going to be hard pressed not to leave a shot here.
Anybody find a missing phone, bring it up to the tournament desk. A missing
calling
phone, bring it up to the tournament desk.
Solid 5.
Somebody calling out there. So if you find a phone, bring it up to the tournament desk.
Now Mark's going to try to hide him again. You got to hide him from two balls in the beginning, since there's no solid or stripe determined yet. Still open table. So you got to keep him off the lowest number of balls, both of them, until it's determined. So you got to protect him from the striped one and the solid one. Yeah, this is a prototype Saratoga ball set. They will be tweaking the colors a little bit. The red threes and orange fives need to be adjusted slightly because they're pretty close, and the yellows need some work because they're a little too light. So just little stuff to make an improvement for those of you who are viewing. Thank you. fallen hand for Mark. Now, as long as you hit the lowest numbered ball, you can shoot a, shoot it into a different, either solid or striped. Just say you shoot the striped one into the solid five that's down there. You can do that and take the solids that way. So it's pretty interesting. I think you're going to see Mark take the stripes. I'd be kind of surprised if he didn't, but you never know. Might be the stripe four ball that's down there that might be bothering him to get position on, but I think he'd be fine. So yeah, he's going to take the stripes. Stripe one, stripe two, and three. The two and three will go into the same pocket. Ugh, that was a terrible shot. And Mark knows it. He's in trouble, you know. He's going to have to make a good kick here on this stripe three ball, and he's elevated. And he doesn't want to give Rodney a shot on the one ball. I missed the whole ball. And cue ball in hand for Rodney. Rodney's got a chance here to take control. So it's now 5-3. Yeah, Saratoga is a pretty interesting game. It's a hybrid of 8-ball and 9-ball. You will shoot either 6 solids or 6 stripes in order, depending on which one you choose, and then the black ball for the win. In the chat, the actual name of this game is Saratoga. It was created in Saratoga, Wyoming, so hence the name, Saratoga. Thank you. See, so Rodney would go from the striped 4 to the striped 5, and then the 8. Well, I call it the 8, but it's just black ball has no number on it. The money ball. Five to four is your score. Rodney racks the balls. Let's run a quick commercial for Town Tips. He's got some work to do here. He does have a shot here on the striped one ball. He's right close to it. Zooming around. Just like that, we're tied at 5. Thank you. Rodney's either going to pick solids or stripes here. He's taking the solids on. He's made it. Now he's going to go for the 2-2 combination. Ugh.
Galaxy S7 phone in a gold color up here. This one is solid. No, it's gold.
Good shot from Monica. He's in a good position now to run this rack out. Sorry, he's on the striped blue ball, the striped two, so he's got to play safety and keep Rodney from the solid two. Now, Rodney might go to the air here and jump. He could if he wanted to, but if he can spin around us and catch the edge, which that's what he's going to do, a slight messe. Oh, he caught the black ball. It's no good. Now Mark needs to go from this strike two down to the strike four ball, navigating some traffic. And how's he doing here? Looks like he got fairly decent, but he's still got to get a shot on the black ball. Came down the plate inside. Touchy shot. Now he's looking at the corner. They called the corner. I mean, swish. 6-5, Mark Vidal. Sonny on the mic. I hope you're enjoying the live stream. We're going to run a quick commercial for Rocket Science. Check it out.
Hi, I'm Rocket Rodney Morris, and welcome to my DVD, Rocket Science.
Cut that commercial short because Mark is breaking the balls. Leading 6-5 in this Race to 11 finals of the Saratoga Division. This game, Saratoga, is a hybrid of 8 ball and 9 ball. And I will post the link in the chat room for those of you who might want to see some of the rules. They are being, I think they're pretty correct on that site, the rules for it. This is the prototype ball set they're using for this game. 1-6 stripes, 1-6 solids, and the black ball. Just run your solids or stripes in order. I know I keep going over it and It's just in case anyone's tuning in who isn't familiar with the game, so they kind of know what's going on. So, my apologies to anyone who I might be annoying. Yeah, you can Google Saratoga pool game rules and find the rules also. For those of you who are watching this on the replay on YouTube or Vimeo. So it's a lot of fun, and it's got a lot of strategy to it. You see some safeties and maneuvering, and you got to be a well-rounded player to play this game. Saw what Mark just did there. He played safe. Now Rodney needs to hit the striped one ball, which is in between. I'll zoom in on that real quick. You see where it is, where he's kicking to. Well, he's elected. He can't. He's not kicking at it. He's just trying to tie up the black ball, and didn't do a good job of it. So Mark wants to play the three ball here and probably break out this solid six and then have a shot on the four. And that's what he's done. I don't know if he's gotten perfect or not. It's close. But he's still got to get shape down here for the solid five. That ball, and it's now 7-5.
Oh no, we played 1 second. Oh, lucky two. Still in. He would have won the first. Now
I'm going to win 11. Table walk, house 11, not getting the 8,
right?
So Mark is leading 7-5 and breaking. See how he does here on the break. Now see this right here, you can roll out also in this game in the first shot, just like in nine ball, if you don't have an opening shot. But he's probably going to play off the striped one ball, since he can't see the solid one ball. And he wants to get safe on both of these one balls, solid and striped. Rodney's going to have to he can really only see the solid one ball, so somehow he's got to play off that and keep Mark off them, you know? So there's a lot of strategy here, and it's a very difficult game. Stripes, obviously, because he has a very easy shot on him. They're all open. The only one that's really tough is the striped four ball. But I think Mark will be all right. It was a good shot. He took the solids, and the only thing is I don't know if he can get a shot here on the three ball. He's got an easy shot on the two, but the three is a little funky. Is in trouble now. Unless Rodney gets to the table, you know, which is inevitable here. He's probably not going to like his chances in this game. Even though he's leading 8-5, you know, Rodney's a comeback kid. I would expect Rodden to get out here. Did a good job there breaking out the stripe 6. Now he's got a shot on the stripe 2. Everything's open. Rodney gets out here, will be 8-6. Now he can make this ball and use Mark's ball if he wants to hold him, which he did. Six is your score. Hey guys, we're going to run a quick commercial. We'll be right back. The balls are tied up, so even though Rodney scratched, it might be a little tough for Mark to get out here. Hey, shout out to my man Easy in the chat room. How you doing, buddy? Yeah, you should stop by. We'll be here tomorrow too. I think they have a 8-ball tomorrow. 8-ball all day long tomorrow. Rodney's not going to be happy with that, and you'd expect Mark to get out from here, but crazier things have happened. He's got cue ball in hand, is going to be shooting the three. All depends on how this breakout turns out for him. And it didn't turn out well. Not well at all. You see where he's ended up. No bueno. Hey, safe travels, ZZ. Wish we could have met up too. It would have been cool. Kicking out to four, but he's got to keep Rodney off that one ball. Tough to do, obviously. He's left Rodney a shot here. Rodney's going to take it on. Strike two. That's the two ball. And then the striped five and the black ball. And, yeah. It'll be 8-7. Mark says that's good. I've seen enough. And it's now 8-7. We're going to run a quick commercial. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Rocket Rodney Morris, and welcome to my DVD, Rocket Science.
As opposed to these solids, but he's going to have to work with it and make it work. He's going to need some very good cue ball here to achieve that. Being frozen here to the rail on this two, he needs to get back for the three, straight up in the corner right where the cue ball is. Not going to be easy.
All right, I'll make it right here, okay?
didn't quite get there. This is a little chop here on the shot. Cue ball will travel back and forth. It's not, you should be fine where the four ball is, but it just won't have a terrible angle on it. It still needs to get on the five. Did he make it? Yes, he did. He's in good shape.
Everything
will
sell for the right price, isn't it? That's the best I've done all weekend. Come on.
All right.
I'll have it for you, okay?
Wow.
What?
He's calling the kick on the five. He knows he made a big mistake there.
Who's better, your mom or your uncle?
He's very disappointed with that. Had a good chance there to tie it up. Now they're going to be battling. Mark's got some work to do. He'll probably play a safety here because of the positioning of Rodney's five ball, you know, being covered by Mark's striped five. He can play off the one and if he wanted to, but it looks like he's shooting. Something with that his striped five ball instead of Rodney's solid five. Trying to go all the way out here. Wow, good effort. A little harder and it would have worked out really good for him. Not sure if he's gonna try to kick this in by the kick this five ball in. I mean, this is a tough situation and it's a huge game. It's either 8-8 or 9-7. Big game. Rodney's calling the five ball. He's missed it, but he's missed it pretty good. If he doesn't scratch, he didn't scratch. You can see how the balls are laying here. Now for Mark to get safe out of this is going to be pretty difficult. No good. He knows it, and we're going to be tied up at 8-8 if Rodney gets out, which I'd bet my money on it that he will. Well, we're tied at 8. Well, guys, we'll be back after this quick commercial break. Stay tuned in.
On the Wire, creative media helps billiards companies increase sales, gives professional pool players a chance to make a living through real sponsorship, and takes new ideas through execution to completion. Through the use of visual aid, video production, photography, social media, and more.
Now, here we go. Tied at 8, Rodney Morris to break. We're going to 11. If Rodney can see the striped one ball, he would prefer to shoot that and take the stripes, obviously, here. But it looks like he might be forced to take the solid one. And look at where the two ball is. The solid two is in bad position for him. So he could play safe. He could try to two rail the solid one and leave his cue ball there and try to cover him up on the stripe and solid ones, because nothing's been determined yet. So you got to play safe on two balls if you're going to do that. Rodney's looking to shoot. Don't know if that two goes anywhere, but Rodney could always play safe and hook mark on the striped one ball. Oh, went into the hole. Well, that's going to be a quick game here. Rodney's gonna get out. I didn't think the two went past. He underhit that ball. He was scared to let it go and get hooked again, so now he's just got to commit and pocket the ball. That's it. There we go. 9-8. And it looks like Mark is going to take a break. And we're going to run some commercials, but we'll be back soon. Stay tuned in, everybody.
Hi, I'm Rocket Rodney Morris, and welcome to my DVD, Rocket Science.
Hey everybody, we're back here. Mark Fidel is racking and about to crack the balls. You're only allowed 3 breaks in a row, you know, and Rodney capitalized on all three of his breaks, so now he has to pass it. And, Mark could easily break and run out this set. Well, not easily, but he can do it. You know, he could break and run out this set. So this will be interesting to see how it plays out. We're just waiting for Rodney to get back, and he should be here in a minute. I see him walking now. Let's see how Mark breaks these balls. Anything but a scratch is what he's rooting for here. Make some balls. Wow, and he's coming with a fantastic break here.
Adam Cisneros, if you're in the room, come up to the tournament desk.
It takes solid to strike. The strikes are nice, but you'd have to go into those balls, just glance them, shoot this strike one into the side, glance them, then the three into the side, like this, and then this would be a quick game. Tied at 9-9. That was a quick one. And that was what Rodney had said to me when Mark just took his break real quick. He goes, you know, Mark, now that he's breaking, that I had to give up the break because I had broken three times in a row. Now he could easily break and run out the set. Let's see how Mark breaks these. Most likely Rodney will get back to the table here because of the way the balls are laying. Although Mark has got a shot on the solid one, you see where the solid two ball is, and it's, it's not in a good spot. Mark could elect to play a safety here to open up with, play off the solid one, and try to hide Rodney on the striped and solid one balls. He's going for the crossbank, just in case. He hasn't left Rodney anything great here. He's calling the solid two ball because he hit the lowest solid or stripe, and see, he played position to play the solid one in the sides, and see, he's got solids now, and you see what has occurred. Now Rodney can cut this one ball up in the corner, no guarantee on a shot, but it's probably what he's going to have to do. Sometimes these things happen in pool. He's called the corner. He's missed it, and I don't know if he's gotten safe. Is he going to get fortunate? Oh, he's gotten a roll there. But that happens. You know, this is pool. Rodney says this is a big roll there. Can you see where he's got his one ball right up on that cue ball. Mark is calling the side pocket. He's going to try to kick at it. He's missed the... Didn't make the strike one in the side pocket. Rodney's going to come to the table with an open shot. Open look here. And a chance to get on the hill first. Big game here. Lots of pressure. Now he wants to get fairly straight in on this five ball. And then the eight would be going in the side pocket. To the hill first and breaking. It's been a good match between these two players. Heck of a set. Going the distance. I think it's going to be curtains here. Rodney can elect to re-break, or since he's made the black ball, or he can take it as a lie. I think he's going to take it as a lie. You can see the layout is pretty good. Just needs to get from this one ball to the two. I mean, there are some work to do here for the solids. He's calling the combination. He's going to take the stripes. Oh, he called the one ball in the corner, sorry. I thought he was playing the combination, my fault. Balls away from taking it down. Wow, heck of a match. And Rodney knows he got a little fortunate in that one rack. But a good match. Good match between these two players. And I appreciate everybody tuning in. This will be it for tonight. Tomorrow we'll have 8-Ball for you guys to tune into. So this is Fast Lenny signing off. Have a good one. And tune in tomorrow for 8-Ball all day long. Saratoga 8-Ball. So Rodney Morris won the 10-Ball earlier, and now he's won the Saratoga event. Will he win the 8-Ball tomorrow? Tune in and find out. Have a good night.
Saratoga that is now down. I want to recap some of the place winners. In fourth place, Justin Reckmeyer from Denver. In third place, Chris McDaniel from Denver. In second place, also from Denver, Mark Vidal. And the 2016 Andy Clough, High Desert Master Saratoga champion, you guessed it, Rocket Rodney Morris, the new Hall of Famer. Congratulations, Rocket, and congratulations to all the finishers and placers in the Master Saratoga division.
Mark, you sure wear a straight and well.